lights out, we're underway in Termas. A wheelie there off the line for Scott Ogden on the number 19 bike, but Sasaki makes the dream start from pole position. Barrera looks like he's going to slot into second place as well, just behind him, but Sasaki leads. He's in a little bit wide though in the first corner. Barrera comes straight on through.
Tell you who had a good start was Alonso. He's gone backwards though into turn one. Minho's also made a good ground. He's up into the top six now as Holgado. Look how far he's moved forward. He started in 10th, he's now taking 4th.
Yeah, and Sasaki's in a bit of a sandwich there, isn't he? Holgado got on his inside coming through turn number 2. Tatsuki Suzuki, fellow Japanese rider, was strong off the line as well. You can just see him there on the 24 bike, tucked in nice now behind Onji for some slipstream down this long back straight. Marrero though it is that leads.
Almanta's now taking Ortola as well on the 92. What a ride this is. He's into the top six now.
And he's making it look so easy. Everything's just so clean, so clinical. This is not a world championship novice we're looking at, is it? He looks like a seasoned pro here, Almanta. Now he's trying to get on par with that group directly ahead of him, which features Masia, Sasaki and Holgado. Masia and Suzuki, Sasaki rather. They've got over 200 appearances at world championship level between them. And Almanta bringing them in hand over fist.
David Munoz update, he's in 13th place at the moment, not making great progress as Dennis
Onju
has gone
down
out of a half second lead. Disaster for the KTM Ironman.
Can you believe it? Look at that. Glum faces down in the Aki Ayo garage. They cannot believe it. Dennis Onju then, he was just setting a red hot pace again. 156.942. On the previous lap, he was the only man on the circuit in the 57s. That lap, he was the only man in the 156s, and he just couldn't run that pace underneath him. The grip wasn't there. He goes down into turn number 11, and that means now then that our race leader is Tatsuki Suzuki by some margin. Big advantage he's got now to his teammate Masu in second place. Here comes Sasaki there now. Got that tight inside line. He's going to go through on Sasaki.
Look at the corner speed.
He won't go through on Almanta. Here comes Suzuki there now. He's got quite a comfortable lead here while this second group barges each other around. Suzuki over the line to start lap 6. 1.9 seconds clear right now is the Japanese man. Almanta second. We've got Sasaki in third place.
Yeah, looking further back, a lot of personal bests further back, and this juking around in this second group is slowing them down. The quickest rider on track last time around was Diogo Moreira, who's regrouped a little bit after that difficult start to the Grand Prix. You'll see him just at the back of this train. It's Moreira in 10th at the moment.
Sasaki back through on Almanta. That was nice on the brakes into turn number 2. Almanta, look at the knowledge that he's gaining here. Summer Crafer, Almanta apparently had a bit near big high side. Sasaki then, he's now at the head of this second group. 17 years of age is David Almanta. Lacking experience at this level, but he's now trying to find a way back through on Sasaki. So good at the end of this back straight. On the inside, he picks off Sasaki again. Sasaki, though, cuts the tight line. He just says, have some of that, pal. He moves Almanta onto the marbles, onto the dirty part of the circuit there. Now, that was aggressive from Ayumu Sasaki. Welcome to World Championship, David Almanta. There is Masia now, just squeezing Almanta out, coming back into third place. So Sasaki, oh no, Sasaki's gone down! Sasaki lost the rear, coming on that change of direction, the flip-flop between 13 and 14 on the helicopter shot. And Ayumu Sasaki, having just had the one position drop penalty for the aggressive move on Almanta, it just goes from bad to worse. Sasaki from pole, he has crashed out here, the Michelin Grand Prix of Argentina. Unlucky 13 for the pole man. Sixth place for Minho.
Yeah, he's just gone past Holgado. Holgado looking to fight back, but here comes Munoz, who's looking to take the pair of them. There's a potential second place in this for the second weekend running for Munoz if he plays his cards right and stays patient. Still 7 laps to go in this Grand Prix. Looking in the background, it looked like he did take both Minho and Holgado.
These are precious World Championship points for his early title charge being gained here, aren't they, potentially, by Munoz. Rapid progress by him. Started back in 16th place on the grid, although he had a scare there. Be very, very careful. Just trying to get the power on that little bit early with a little bit too much lean angle. Out of the seat he was briefly coming out the first corner. Oh no, Jammer Massey has gone down. Well, we were just talking about the prospect. What looked a nailed on 1-2 for Leopard Honda, but Jaume Masia has bitten the dust. He just fired in that 155.9, the best lap of the Grand Prix, but that pace was just too hot for that front Dunlop tyre. Masia down into turn number 2, and this battle now for what was third is now for second place. It's now in the hands of Artigas.
Munoz shaping up, but he's not able to make his way through. On Artigas ahead of him, Moreira is, though, as he gets past the other Cifmoto, and that's Artigas and Munoz going down in stereo.
Well, tandem crashes, wasn't it? Xavi Artigas was the first man to go down, and then David Munoz losing big, big world championship points here early on. High drama here in Moto3 in South America. João Amasia crashed out to second place, and now Artigas and Munoz, when positioned to fight for the podium, they have both gone down within milliseconds of each other in turn number 13. It's all down to Almansa, Moreira, Holgado, Minho, Ogden and Rossi. They're all in contention for the final two place on the podium. It's tight there between Minho and Ogden. They lean on each other going through turn number five, but it's Moreira that has the advantage.
Very different braking techniques from Moreira and Almansa there, but both equally effective into turn five. Moreira, of course, for the South Americans, is the sole South American in this leading battle, currently holding second place, and of course the World Championship implications for this. We're expecting Moreira and Holgado to be World Championship contenders late into this season. Of course, with Munoz out of play, there's an opportunity for them to stretch an early lead in this World Championship. Moreira in second from Almansa, Minho, Holgado and Ogden. Artigas up there, he is still running. He's battling with Stefano Nepa for 8th and 9th.
There's a big gang group ganging up behind Andre Minho. Almansa moves side by side, elbow to elbow. Moreira also trying to use some slipstream as well. They're almost on the white kerb there, aren't they, on the inside? Here comes Scott Ogden as well on the number 19 bike. But it's
Rossi.
Moreira that wins that battle. Oh no! Ogden cleans out Almansa. And that's a nightmare. So, so cruel for poor old David Almansa. On course for a Dream World Championship debut. Almansa down. Now through the final couple of corners, Minho, a little bit of a wobble there on the gas. They came through turn number 12. Rossi's gone down. He goes careering into the gravel trap, bike cartwheels through the gravel, but it's Tatsuki Suzuki who reigns supreme here in Termas. He wins the Moto3 Grand Prix of Argentina. Late drama throughout the field at the checkered flag. Suzuki takes it by 4.5 seconds. He led by 7.5 seconds at one point. Diogo Moreira, who was the early leader, he did slip back to 11th at one stage. He fights back to a stunning second place. And what a return to Grand Prix action for Andrea Minho, replacing Fallon there on the CIP Green Power machine. But congratulations then to Tatsuki Suzuki. It's a third career victory for Suzuki, his first in 50 Grand Prix.